Hey everyone, it's Gus from Arduino My Life Up, and today I'm going to go through how to connect and control a 16x2 LCD. There is a ton that you're able to do with a liquid crystal display, or more commonly known as an LCD. It's a good little device to learn how to connect and communicate with. You will find that most LCD boards are not assembled with header pins, so these will need to be soldered on. If you have some header pins, then this isn't too much of a task. You can probably skip soldering, but getting a good connection to the board will be difficult. The potentiometer you find in this circuit is used to control the brightness of the screen. If you find nothing is displaying or it just doesn't look quite right, then try turning this up or down. The circuit for the Arduino LCD is actually surprisingly easy. You'll find that the most off-putting thing about it is how many wires there are that needs to be hooked up. So if you have an LCD display that needs to be soldered, it's a pretty straightforward process. Place the header pin so that the short side sticks up through the holes on the display. Now solder the pins one by one, ensuring that you don't accidentally connect two up. If you do accidentally connect two up, then you'll need to use something like a solder sucker to get rid of the excess solder, then try to do it again. Once done, it's ready to use. Now you will need the following pieces of equipment to get this project together. The Arduino Uno, the 16x2 LCD board, a 10k ohm potentiometer, or also known as a pot, breadboard wire, and of course a breadboard. So to get the circuit hooked up, place the screen onto the breadboard. Place the pot onto the breadboard. First hook the 5V pin from the Arduino to the positive line on the breadboard. Now hook the ground pin to the ground rail on the breadboard. Place the following wires to the LCD screen, with pin 1 being the closest to the edge of the board. Ground rail to pin 1, pin 5 and pin 16 of the LCD, and also add one wire to the ground pin of the pot. Now for the positive 5V rail, wire to pin 2 and pin 15 of the LCD, and also one wire to the positive pin of the pot. Now take a wire from the middle pin on the pot to pin 3 of the LCD. Now let's wire the following Arduino digital pins to the LCD pins. So pin 12 on the Arduino to pin 4, pin 11 to pin 6, pin 5 to pin 11, pin 4 to pin 12, pin 3 to pin 13, pin 2 to pin 14. Now if you got lost in all that, I have a really easy to read diagram over at the full tutorial on ArduinoMyLifeUp.com. If you're having trouble, be sure to go check that out. Now that's all done, it's time to move on to the code. The code for communicating with a display is actually pretty straightforward. You may have thought whilst connecting up all these wires that the code's going to be over complicated, but gladly it's not. Thanks to a helpful library called Liquid Crystal. This is included in Arduino's main library collection. It's important to know that there are already examples within the Arduino software. To find them, simply go to File, Examples, and then Liquid Crystal. In here you'll find a range of different examples, with each showing you how to use certain methods of the Liquid Crystal library. To begin, I suggest taking a look at the Hello World example. In the code you will need to set up a variable of type Liquid Crystal, as you can see here. Liquid Crystal LCD 12 11 5 4 3 2. The numbers that are passed as parameters represent the pin number on the Arduino we have connected to the relevant pin on the display. Here is an example of a function again, but instead it contains the corresponding pins on the LCD. Liquid Crystal RS enable D4, D5, D6, D7. The datasheet for your LCD board will contain the pin number and their type. For example, here is the datasheet for my board. As you can see, DB4 equals D4, E equals enable, and so on. The function that I mentioned before can be also extended to read from 8 data lines in total. For example, RS enable D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, and D7. LCD.begin, located in the setup function, is used to initialize the interface to the LCD. Here is where you will need to specify how many columns and rows there are on the display. For example, my display has 16 columns and 2 rows. This means we need to set it up with 16 as the first parameter and 2 as the second parameter. If you ever need to clear the display, then simply call the method lcd.clear. This will wipe the display so that you can display a new value on there. Make sure you have a delay beforehand so you're able to see whatever is being displayed on the screen before it is wiped. If you ever want to move a cursor back to home or position 1 rather than clearing the display, then lcd.home will do this. If you just want to print a string on the LCD, then the print method is what you will need. Just simply call it like this, lcd.print, then your string. The last basic method that I will mention is write. This method is used to write a character to the screen. Very much like print, simply call it like this, lcd.write, then your character. Now there are a ton of other methods that you're able to use. I go through these in a bit more depth over at arduinomylifeup.com. You'll also find a script that I have prepared that will show an example of each of these methods. Now there is a ton of things you're able to do with an LCD screen. I will touch on just a few ideas that I am thinking of covering in the future. If you have any of your own ideas that you'd like to share, then be sure to leave a comment below or over at arduinomylifeup.com. Now you could bundle this with a temperature sensor and have a digital temperature display for your fish tank, room, outside, or just wherever you'd like to know the temperature. You would probably want to use one of these if you're planning on making an Arduino clock, for example. Now I have covered an Arduino die circuit before, but instead of using the LEDs, you could use the LCD to display the outcome of a roll. Just keep the switch and replace the rest with the screen. Now there is a huge amount of potential that you're able to do with the LCD. I'll be looking at doing some future projects that incorporates this cool part. Now, I hope that you have the Arduino LCD display hooked up and working correctly. If I have got anything wrong, or you have some feedback, or just anything else, then be sure to leave a comment below or over at arduinomylifeup.com. Until next time, have a good one. Thanks for watching. Be sure to check out these 21 Arduino projects that anyone can do. If you want to stay up to date with the latest and greatest Arduino projects and much more, then please subscribe.